I have a amplifier, so this is figure 10.8. I have a voltage amplifier, negative feedback voltage amplifier, with a operational amplifier as controller. You see the voltage attenuation from the output, RA, RB. Across RB, we have the feedback voltage, and if the controller is doing its work, then this voltage will be made equal to VS, resulting, of course, in some in the output voltage exactly being RA plus RB divided by RA times the input voltage. So if the controller is annuller, we have the ideal gain written in expression 10.29. Now we will apply for this controller an operational amplifier, but not a just normal voltage-controlled voltage source. I want to apply a more complex operational amplifier that of which the model has two controlled sources. That is just for explaining how this selection of the reference variable works. So here I have a current feedback operational amplifier. The output is referred to ground, and there is an input, and it's an asymmetrical input, as you know, from the current feedback operational amplifier. But for this case, the most important is we have two controlled sources. And I can now select, so I can put this operational amplifier, this small signal diagram, into this circuit, and then I obtain this circuit. And this circuit can be the start of my evaluation of the loop gain and the asymptotic gain, etc. The ideal gain we already did. The ideal gain here to 10.29 is RA plus RB divided by RA. And we just say this can be calculated if we replace the operational amplifier with a nuller, the ideal controller. But now we put the operational amplifier in the circuit, and we want to know what is the asymptotic gain and, for example, the loop gain, and how can we write the source to load transfer with the aid of this asymptotic gain feedback model. But we have two things that we can select as loop gain reference, and that is what this topic is about. We can select the voltage controlled current source G1, or we can select the current controlled voltage source H1 as loop gain reference. Now, before we are going to go through the script or the calculation and show the result, let's just do it on circuit inspection, intuition, not really intuition, but more by circuit inspection. We stated the following. If we select a reference variable and we let this reference variable approach infinity, then the ideal gain equals the asymptotic gain if the controller behaves as a nuller. Let's see. Let's select G1 as loop gain reference, which means that if GM, which is the gain of G1, approaches infinity, then the ideal gain equals the asymptotic gain if the currents in both nodes are zero and the voltage across between node 2 and node 5 becomes zero. Now let's see what happens. If I make the gain GM infinite, it means that this source can produce any current without needing a voltage. So indeed, the voltage of node 2 equals the voltage as node 5, so the input voltage of the controller will be zero. But now the question is also the input current zero? Well, if the gain of H1 is not infinite, and it doesn't need to be because we selected G1 as reference variable, then for any output voltage, I still need a driving current. And this driving current will be delivered by GM and flow in a negative input terminal of my controller. Which means by selecting G1 as reference variable, the controller does not become a nuller if the loop gain approaches infinity. So that we will see later on, it should be confirmed with an analysis done with SLICAP. Let's do the other one. If I select H1 as reference variable, it means that the loop gain, the asymptotic gain, will equal the ideal gain if the controller becomes a nuller, if H1, the gain of this one, which is AR, becomes infinity. Let's see. If the gain AR becomes infinity, then it means that the device H1 does not need any input current to produce any output voltage. So the current at the input will be zero. This means that G1 does not need to produce any current. And if the gain is not zero, it means it does not need any voltage to do so. Which means that both the voltage between node 2 and node 5 will become zero, and the current in node 2 and the current, in the positive input and the current in the negative input becomes zero. Which means that if I select H1 as reference variable, then the controller becomes a nuller if the gain of the reference variable approaches infinity. So for having a meaningful expression for the loop gain, so that we can replace the asymptotic gain with the ideal gain and have our two-step design, I would like to select H1 as reference variable. SlyCap supports the negative feedback model, the asymptotic gain model. And a powerful thing of the asymptotic gain model is that the transfer from source to load is always correct if you calculate it direct from network theory or you calculate it from the model. That was what we have concluded with the model. But it is only a meaningful model if the asymptotic gain equals the ideal gain, because then the loop gain is a measure for the deviation of the actual transfer from the ideal transfer. That is what you should remember. It's maybe a little bit abstract, but it's very important, because in many situations, and especially when you are going to transistor level design, it is almost impossible to select the reference variable in that way. And you always have multiple loops. You can select the reference variable in a local loop, and then you may draw conclusions from the loop gain that are not at all true. And unfortunately, this is often done. And this is why I stress this so much. So let's go to SlyCap. You know, there was a thing like a gain type in SlyCap. We have already used gain type VI for noise analysis and gain for finding a transfer from source to load. But basically, SlyCap supports the asymptotic gain model. So gain type can be gain, asymptotic, direct, loop gain, or servo. And VI, of course, but it's not relevant for this, for the negative feedback model. So gain, source to load transfer, calculated just from modified nodal analysis. The asymptotic gain calculated when the reference variable is replaced with a nuller. That's what it's doing. The gain of the reference variable becomes infinite, which is the same as replacing the reference variable itself with a nuller. So not the controller, the reference variable. Direct transfer, direct stands for the direct transfer. It means that we set the gain of the reference variable to zero. The loop gain, as defined by as the gain enclosed in the loop with respect to the selected loop gain reference variable, and the servo function calculated from the loop gain. So here you find the function, if you want to set the loop gain reference, wrong. This should be capital small, small letter, but you find it in the help file. I will update this. So set LG ref means you define the loop gain reference. So that are instructions that are available. Let's go to Python where I'm doing this. You see here, I have a circuit. This current feedback op-amp, you can open the book and see in the book, you can see the circuit, because there's no LTSPICE picture here. So here, this is the circuit that is there that we are talking about. So the source is VI and the detector is V at node 4. You see node 4 is the load voltage. Loop gain reference can be either selected G1 or H1, and I would like to show you the difference in selecting one or the other with this file. So first, I will calculate the loop gain with G1 as loop gain reference, and you see I set the gain type, and I calculate the Laplace transfer function, then I set the gain type to loop gain, to servo, to direct, and I'll print all these things on a page. Then I will change to, this was the HTML file, sorry, H1, because I'm setting the loop gain. Oh, here, I'm changing loop gain reference to H1, and I'm doing everything again. I make a page and put all the results on there with H1 as loop gain reference. So we should have, that's what we expect, exactly the same transfer if I calculate the gain, because the gain is calculated with modified nodal analysis, and it has nothing to do with the loop gain reference. But if I calculate the gain according to the asymptotic gain model, which I'm doing here, the asymptotic gain times the servo function plus the direct transfer divided by 1 minus the loop gain. So if I calculate the gain according to this definition, it should always be the same as the result from the modified nodal analysis, so the gain itself. But the loop gain and the servo and the direct transfer can be different. They depend, and the asymptotic gain, of course, they depend on the selection of the reference variable. So I can run this. And here, two pages, one with G1 as reference variable. And then remember, we expect that the asymptotic gain does not equal the ideal gain. So the loop gain does not describe the error, is not a measure for the error that our amplifier is going to make with respect to the ideal gain. We need more parameters, which means it's difficult to make a two-step design. That is what this is all about. So here, you see the asymptotic gain doesn't look at all like the ratio of two of a few resistors. There is also a gain of this elements of the op-amp in it. And but of course, if you look at the source to load transfer, here's the source to load transfer, calculated according to modified nodal analysis, gain type is gain. And here at the bottom, we have the same source to load transfer, but now it is calculated according to the asymptotic gain model. And you see the results are the same. It means that our model, the feedback model, gives the correct result for the source of low and load transfer, but it's not useful for a two-step design because we selected the wrong loop gain reference. Now let's go to the other one, because there we explained that it was the correct selection. If the gain of this H1 approaches infinity, then the asymptotic gain should equal the ideal gain. And now look, by doing this, you see that the asymptotic gain with selected H1 is RA plus RB divided by RB. That is what we want. That's the ideal gain. So now the loop gain is a meaningful thing. It tells us that we have to increase this thing with all its contributions, all this, everything is in it, to improve to make the amplifier, the gain of the amplifier equal to its ideal gain or approach its ideal gain. And of course, the transfer from source to load has not changed, only the way that the asymptotic gain, the loop gain, and the servo function are defined. So remember that we must have a meaningful selection. And for op-amps, it's obvious, it's always very obvious. Let's say it's simple, but later on in transistor design, this really becomes important. And we must understand that in order to have a meaningful thing for the loop gain, we must have a proper selection of the reference variable. This is illustrated in this thing, and that's why I selected this a little bit complex model for operational amplifier, because then we have two controlled sources of which we can select one or the other as reference.